Sometimes you want to consolidate audio or MIDI just for convenience or to save some CPU. In Cubase, you have three ways to do this within the project window, so without really exporting. One way is bound selection, and that's a quick way to get one solid file if you've been doing some splitting, some fading. Also, if you've done audio warping, pitch correction, those are heavy on the computer. So select, bound selection, and it's warning me that it's going to replace the event. If you want to keep the original close, then before you bounce, go to track versions, duplicate track version, then bounce. And now you can always go back to the unbounced version. The second way is render in place. This one has some more options. You can choose what the events will look like, what processing you want to include. Dry will just bounce and have your effects on the new track, but you can also include just the channel settings, the whole signal path, and even the master effects. Here you can choose to have a tail and how long you want it to be, the bit depth of the processing, you can name the new file, choose a file location, and what's going to happen with the source events. And then to make sure the CPU is no longer affected by the original track, right-click it, disable, and to clean it up, you can hide it. If you don't necessarily need a new audio file to work with, but you do want to save some CPU, then freeze is a good option. That's this little snowflake here. And if you click it, you can choose to have a tail on the audio file that's created in the backend, so you won't see it in the project. So I'll just click OK. And now my frozen track still looks the same, it sounds the same, but I can't edit it. Same for MIDI. Here I get some extra options to include inserts and unload the instrument, and I also can't edit it, but they will play back normally. If I do want to make an adjustment, I have to unfreeze it. And you can also do it by right-clicking, by the way. And then you can choose to delete or keep the freeze files. And lastly, if you've been hiding a lot of tracks and you want to bring back one specific track to make some adjustments, then go to the left zone, visibility tab. If you don't see that, right-click on inspector and check it. And now you can see all of your tracks, including the hidden ones, but those are not checked. So if you've named your tracks, you can very easily find the one you need. And just click here. Now it's back and you can right-click, enable, and make the adjustments. So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video, subscribe, and have fun making music.